in the blue corner, Khaled Al Jasser. In the red corner, Bogdan Zarcu-v-Khaled.
Bogdan Zarcu, the hometown favorite, versus Khaled Al Jasser, a judoku from Scotland. He made the long trip yesterday, and he's here to fight.
Here we go. Wow. Bogdan's an ex-professional rugby player, and he fights like one. Simple as that.
Definitely.
You seen him on that last show, mate. He probably threw about, let's say, 60 punches from the mouth.
Definitely. He came wow. in swinging, and he was looking to do the same today. He's trying to set it up, get comfortable.
And what I know of Khaled Al Jasser, he's a judo boy, is he?
He definitely is. He's looking really, really good in there right now. He's got that excellent judo strength. He gets staggered there. Bogdan smells blood, and he's moving in for the kill.
The judo boys have good leg locks. All the judo boys are good at leg locks, and it's going to be hard to get off that big boy. He's a bull.
You definitely can't outcredit the strength of judoku, but
you combine the, you know, you got to forget that he trains at Gracie Jiu-Jitsu. He's not just coming off a rugby field. These guys train proper jiu-jitsu.
He's got excellent posture there. He's got the hips in. He's really weighing down right now on Khaled. Let's see what Khaled's answer is.
It's all up to Khaled now.
He spins out. He's looking excellent there.
Credit to him. He's got arm.
Khaled's fighting
arm
the wrist.
Control there.
Oh, there's the judoku there.
Good boys. Very good. Very good.
Khaled coming into this fight is 4-0. He's looking on the ropes right now.
I think, yeah. Low blow.
We got a slight low blow.
Good sportsmanship. And here we go again. Khaled Al Jasser, VT Jiu-Jitsu, obviously.
He's looking a little more tentative. No,
that's Lee's gym, is it, yeah?
Yes, it is. Lee Remedios in his corner.
You're not going to get a much better cornerman than Lee Remedios.
Definitely.
I knew of Lee when I was in Australia way back when he fought UFC, and he was the pioneer. Before Michael Binspig was even getting out of nappies.
Oh, a spinning back fist.
I actually seen him go for that before. He turned that weird angle.
Looking for the double. Bogdan going high for that guillotine.
Again, judo. Judo don't do double legs.
He sags out of that guillotine very well.
The crowd is going crazy. And I want to pay credit to Michael Canis. He's done everything for this show. He's the promoter, matchmaker. He's done everything for this show.
Yes, Michael has definitely put together some great matches for us tonight.
He has made matchups that they could be on any show. These fights, really, you're a credit to the sport.
The chants are starting. Bogdan is controlling the center of the cage very well.
The home crowd, really. Jeez. I think Bogdan's going to wait for that uppercut again.
Khaled needs to be using his range, that's for sure.
There's not
a little bit more footwork
with
head move.
They look to be sucking in the big ones there, too.
When you have a big boy on top of you like that, it's hard to get him off, and Khaled's done very well so far.
I think he's playing possum. I think he was pretending to be hurt then.
Excellent leg kick.
Bogdan is chasing. 10 seconds to go.
We get the 10-second warning there.
10 seconds to go. Will we get to the second round?
Great body kick there.
Awesome round. Well done to Khaled for making it through that round.
I'd have to score that for Bogdan, though, with excellent submission attempts, a great overhand right a few times there, and really working the cage and controlling it as well. Let's see how Khaled answers back in that second round.
Again, I just want to point out that neither of these guys looks to be too puffed. Yeah, they might be taking a breath, but they're both in the fight. It's happened in every fight. every team has brought a fighter ready to fight on this show. Well done to all the gyms.
And that's definitely the draw of Rumble on the Rock. It's a great first class, first choice type of event where everybody is received in a great way, and you want to perform on this show, that's for sure.
That's it.
I know I did.
And you did.
What can I say?
Lee Remedios pointing out some good pointers there, telling his fighter to stick on the end of a long jab, which would be the same advice I would give when you're fighting a bigger guy, to move on your feet and sit on the end of a long jab, which is going to be hard because Bogdan, he's not going to sit on the end of the jab. He's going to bull rush and he's going to try and slam you on your head.
And like you said, with that rugby background, like he can take a hit. He can take a hit and he'll keep moving forward, Jai, that's for sure.
Both guys come out, touch gloves, and here we go again. And
the
crowd is straight back into it. They love Bogdan.
They really do. Both fighters feeling each other out.
Doing a bit of training with Bogdan, and he really is a nice guy, but you won't see that in the cage tonight. You won't see a lot of nice guy. Maybe after the fight.
And that's true. Our fighters are some of the most sportsmanlike in the sport. Well, Khaled switching stances there.
He's yet to stick on that jab. Oh. If he throws long punches, he'll make things a little bit more difficult.
He continues to duck under when he gets inside, which is great for Bogdan if he's looking for that uppercut.
Yes.
Being a little shorter fighter, he can get those inside shots tight and inside. And he's already sent Khaled staggering. Again.
I would imagine both these boys have knockout power.
Definitely.
Oh.
Bogdan really measured him up there.
That one would have landed up in the back row. We don't play baseball in Australia, we play cricket, and that would have been a six.
Bogdan needs to set up those punches.
Another low blow, was it?
Yep. A little bit of a knee there from Khaled. Lands
that's
flush.
Even.
I think
that
so, one and one.
That just makes it even.
He's getting a no-no. He's got to go to a neutral corner.
He's all right. I think he just wants to get his faculties back together.
And that can really take the wind out of you, that's for sure.
Ladies, that does not feel good.
They go back to their respective corners, and they're ready to go again.
You could wear five cups. It's still going to hurt. The jewels still shake inside that money box.
I think I heard it clank, that's for sure.
jingle bells.
See, the only issue here with Khaled is that he's leaving that right elbow outside when he throws that jab, which is really telegraphing it to Bogdan.
That's right.
He's using some good footwork. We want to see some action here. Both fighters still feeling each other out. They know they're dangerous. They know what positions they're in. Let's see what happens here. Bogdan looking for an
excellent scissor sweep.
He's a creative kid, that's for sure. A lot of confidence.
The scissor sweep. Oh, I haven't seen one of them in a while. And they do work. They do work.
We've seen it with Anderson Silva and Rio Chonan back in the Pride days.
That's right. Both guys' hands are dropping here. Anything could happen.
And you commented on it earlier, Jai, but both of these fighters are in excellent condition. They're looking for the finish. They're looking to keep the pace going.
Oh, Bogdan's successful with that right hand. He's throwing that right hand with the left hook after. And
he's measuring it well.
Really,
he's
working.
Getting the torque over with that right hip.
He's not rushing. Was that the tap for the 10-second bell? I heard a noise. I wasn't sure.
It was hard to hear it over this crowd. Wonder if the fighters heard it themselves.
Oh, that was a nice. That a nice push front, but more of a stabbing one. And they do hurt. Second round, getting those low body shots.
Here. Some very creative strikes here by Khaled. He's really looking to light him up, but he could look to chop those legs a little bit more.
He's going to turn for that back fist again. You can see when he rolls that shoulder forward. He's going to, I knew there was a spinning something. It's always a hint when they roll that shoulder forward.
What a right hand. That hook
was
incredible.
What a Khaled. He's not just going backwards. When he gets hit, he circles. That hurt. I heard that.
But Bogdan's still controlling that center of the cage,
That
is really what's going to stick in the mind of the judges. Khaled needs to have an answer for that. He needs to control the cage, circle, oh, and look for the angles on his own punches. Bogdan Khaled, definitely going for the knockout.
Khaled is trying to get Bogdan off his game a little here, trying to stir him up a little bit. A takedown at the end of the round would be just a little polish, just to end of the round, good. And again, sportsmanship. Both guys give each other five.
Excellent work. Lee Romeridos back in for the corner of Khaled Al-Jassar. It's looking like 2-1 right now, Jayan.
2-1 to Bogdan. He's going forward. I think towards the end of that round, Khaled seemed to loosen up a bit. Started moving his shoulders around. And
indeed,
I think that'll work for him. He seems to have a big bag of tricks.
Definitely. And coming here, fighting on this show, especially with a hometown boy, it's got to be a lot of nerves. Breathing is very important here. Khaled is sweating, but not puffing. Again, like you said, both fighters looking in great shape. They've come game for this, that's for sure. Let's see what this third and final round holds in store for us. Khaled's answer should be to keep his hands up against Bogdan. We see him throwing that really big overhand looping right hook, and that can cause serious damage even with the hands up.
I think both fighters could be advised to just get their hands up a little bit. You don't want to get this far, Bogdan being 2 rounds up, and get caught with something just because the hands are down. He's trained hard. He knows what to do.
Again, game.
And here we go, third
round. Center of the cage.
I'd like to see Khaled loosen up a bit and use this repertoire that he's got. He is dangerous. Very dangerous.
He's throwing that jab well to start off the round. Bogdan has been able to really counter with that right hand, and against a southpaw fighter, that is exactly what you should be looking for, that right hand or that left hook.
Oh, now I know why he went for the scissor. Scissor's way more effective on the southpaw.
Indeed.
There you go.
Khaled looks like he is comfortable in here. He's still coming out, he's still game. Bogdan inching forward.
You have to look at these two corners. I'm noticing now, You've got Toppy from the Gracie Barrett Channel Islands, who I've managed to have a role with a couple of times, and the guy is smooth. His stand-up is fantastic, and his jiu-jitsu is phenomenal.
Indeed.
He Bogdan basically really mauled me when I went into the gym, and you look over on the other corner, and Khaled's got Lee Remedios.
Oh, a staggering right hand. Bogdan is mixing it up right now with those leg kicks and coming over top with those right hands. This is what he wants to do. He wants to push the pace. He doesn't want this to go to the judges.
That's right.
Always the showman.
He's looked at the leg. I wonder if he's like pretending to go for the leg, but he's gonna go high. Oh.
And again, Khaled is circling out very well.
Oh, spinning back kick, eh? They're dangerous.
He can throw those strikes. He's got to know that he's down 2-0, and he's got to start working forward. He's got to push forward and look for his own game plan. I'm surprised he hasn't tried to clinch up a little bit more with Bogdan.
I think he knows.
Excellent tilt and whirl. He's smiling.
He would have to be aware that he's 2 rounds down, and he needs to end the fight.
And we're running out of time here.
I'm not sure how he's going to do it, but he's going to have to come out with something special.
Again, fighters with their hands down is not a good place to be. They need to keep those guards up, both fighters with knockout power. Bogdan throwing those looping overhand rights, and Al-Jassar looking good for those unorthodox strikes.
Good exchange there, good exchange. And again, I like the way Khaled's moving around the cage. He's not just going backwards and forwards, and it is troubling Bogdan. But Bogdan, like a warship, I think he's just zoning in. He's going to send a big bomb in there.
There we go.
Sometime soon.
That's what needed to happen a little bit more. We've got to mix up those strikes a little bit more.
A takedown now would be great. Assert his authority on the round. And
Bogdan, a short, stocky fighter, just slamming those leg kicks in. Both fighters have much to improve upon, but they
Bogdan
are
with a push
excellent
run, just to mix it up and show that they're well-rounded, these guys. They're
definitely
well-rounded. Gracie Barrow gone 2-0. Ben Speed with the draw
and
tonight.
And again, Bogdan pushes the action.
The crowd could have argued it, but I think the judges made a good decision. And don't leave it in the judges' hands.
He tries that clinch. It's really hard for a judoku in MMA. As soon as the sweat gets in there, they get slippery. They can't be thrown as easily. It's very difficult to do.
A lot of judo guys struggle when the gi is off. There's a big difference between judo with a gi and not with a gi.
We get that 10-second warning.
Some will adapt and some won't.
Taking the center of the cage like he's done, like it's been really the tempo.
He's looking to finish. Come on, great fight.
Excellent show of sportsmanship.
I actually didn't think that'd go all the way. So surprise me. Good work to both the boys.
That unorthodox style of Al Jasser has really served him well. Didn't allow Bogdan to get the knockout. Bogdan looking excellent tonight for the Channel Islands. And Gracie Barra.
Decision been made. The judges have decided that from the red corner, Gracie Barra, Channel Islands. All done, Zarcu! We have two-time winner here on Rumble on the Rock. Bogdan, you're a bit of a favourite here. I love you. I remember your last fight you had here. You went like a bull out the gates, and credit to Khaled, I was expecting that to be over very quick. I was very impressed with your patience. You were very patient in that fight. Big credit to your trainers.
Thank you. Yeah, on the first fight, it was a different opponent. That was my first fight, and that was my game. Now I was more patient because of my trainers. I want to thank you on this occasion for my trainers, Topo, Stu, Rob, and all the guys to the gym. Thank you.